As you can see, I have a triangle shape here. If I go to the transform section of shape layer, you can see the anchor point option. The anchor point is the middle point of shape, but you can change the place, which I will teach you later. If you pay attention, the anchor point is the first parameter of transform section, because you have to set anchor point before other transform items. Because the position of anchor point can affect on many items of transform section. For example, when I change the rotation, the triangle rotates around the anchor point. Now let me reset the rotation. If I change the scale, the resize will apply from the anchor point. Okay, let me reset it too. Now let me change the position of anchor points to understand better its effect. I will move it here. Now I change the rotation value again. You can clearly see that the triangle revolves around the new anchor point position. Let me also change the scale to see the effect of anchor point movement. You can even put the anchor point out of your shape. For example, I will set it at this point. As you can see, the anchor point is one of the main items of each layer in After Effects. Let me reset the transform section. Now it's time to look at the effect of anchor point on position. To start, I set anchor point at this point. Then, at the beginning of timeline, I create a keyframe for position and set it. Now, I go a little further and I change the position to create the second keyframe for me. Now, you can see that the anchor point is moving along the path. I like to create keyframe for rotation and scale, so that we can handle the effect of anchor point position more accurately. You can use transform section to move the anchor point. As you can see, there are two numeric boxes for the x and y coordinates. By changing these numbers, you can see that the anchor point remains in place and the shape moves itself. In fact, by changing these numbers, the shape will shift in the way that the ratio of the shape position and anchor point is adjusted correctly. But there is an easier way to move anchor point, and that is to use pan behind tool. You can find pan behind tool inside After Effects toolbar. The shortcut key is Y. To work with it, just select the pan behind tool and click on the anchor point. Now you can move it to where you want. As simple as you see. You can also use some useful shortcut keys to set the anchor point. By pressing the shortcut keys Ctrl+Alt+Home, you can set the anchor point in the center of the shape. And by pressing Ctrl+Home, you can set the anchor point in the center of composition. And if you hold down Shift key, when you're moving anchor point with the pan behind tool, you can move the anchor point in a straight line. There is also very useful and practical plugin for setting the anchor point. Move Anchor Point 4 plugin. You can buy this plugin from AES Group site. I put the link in description. You can see the compatible versions in this section. After installing Move Anchor Point 4, you can come to the window menu, and from the extensions, you can see the Move Anchor Point 4. I choose it. In this composition, I have made three shapes. Now, I select the triangle. You can see this box in Move Anchor Point 4. By the options in this box, you can easily adjust the position of anchor point. For example, when I click on this option, you can see that the anchor point is snapping in upper corner of the shape. Using Move Anchor Point 4 will greatly increase your speed For example, now I choose all three shapes. You can adjust the anchor point of the all shapes at once. Now let me show you another feature of Move Anchor Point 4. By clicking on the object, the other two options are shown, selection and composition. I select the selection and I click on this option. The anchor points of all shapes are set in this point. In selection mode, the anchor point of all selected objects are set in one point. Now, if I rotate all shapes, you will see that all shapes rotate relative to their new anchor point position. In composition mode, the anchor points of all objects are set to relative to different composition points. This is the end of this tutorial and I hope you enjoyed watching it and it will be useful for you. At the end, don't forget to like this video.